This tree here is a beautiful old majestic eucalyptus tree, guys, or an old gum tree. Just in the middle of the paddock, basically. So this tree would have been left here purely for shade for the sheep. And also, you can see those stumps sticking out. I just saw some galahs fly out of those hollows, the hollow stumps. That's where they'd be nesting at the moment. So there's probably baby chicks in those hollows. And this tree here, I reckon, would be probably at least 300 years old, maybe less or more. I'm not an expert, but it's a beautiful old gum tree. I think it might be called, I don't know, salmon gum or a white gum. But over 100 years ago, guys, you can see all these other gum trees in the distance. This whole area for thousands and thousands of square kilometres would have been just littered with these gum trees. So when the farmers settled here 100 years ago, all these trees would have been pulled down, and so the farmers could clear the land and produce wheat and farm their sheep. So no fault of their own to the farmers. So I'm not putting any blame on the farmers. It's just the way it is all over the world. Here is an old mallee tree, and these trees are pretty famous for their wood, mallee roots. But I'll give you a bit of a tip in regards to snakes. A lot of snakes live in these mallee trees down the roots. I have seen snakes actually go into them. So these mallee root trees, like for example here, it's probably a hollow in there. So during the winter, when the snakes hibernate, the snakes will go in here and curl up and sleep for the rest of the winter. Like I say, I have seen huge snakes, like dugite snakes, that are deadly and have killed people in the past. And they go into hollows like this at the bottom of mallee root trees, and like I say, curl up and hibernate for the rest of the year. So it's starting to get warm now, guys, so within the next month, snakes will be coming out, so I'll definitely have to be watching my dogs. The last thing I want is for them. Just here, guys, is an old mallee root. So these are a lot of woodwork turners like these, or furniture makers, you know, the really big ones you can make beautiful tables out of, or clocks and all other types of woodwork. And also, the mallee root is obviously very, very famous in Western Australia. I'm not too sure about over east, I think over east as well, for the firewood, because this firewood is really, really good, and it burns hot and for a long time. And as you can see down there, this is the bottom of the mallee root. So that would have been sitting like that under the ground, and the snakes, you know, would curl or sleep underneath these roots. Just here's another mallee root just here, what's dead. So if I wanted to, I could easily kick that out and take it home for firewood, but I'm not, because it's probably an animal. We never know, it could even be a little snake living in there, or a mouse, or something native. But yeah, I just thought I'd give you a bit of information about the good old trusty mallee root.
Guys, this is a perfect example how most, if not all, farmers in Western Australia, and probably over east, have their paddock entrance gate set up. So basically it's just a star picket there, goes along here to the other star pickets, what keep it upright, and there it's pretty easy to open. So basically this here is wrapped around there, some wire, very easy. You lift that up, like that, and open that, and the gate just falls down. All farmers' kids, or you know, if you're working in a farm, you get sick of opening up gates. It's always, okay, your turn, mate, to open it. Oh, not again, Dad, you know. So I thought I'd give you
bit of info about the old tree.
Now guys, we'll head up to the other turnip wheat patch, so I'll see you up there, maybe. Well guys, I've finished picking turnips for the turnip weeds for the day, so I'm going to head off home now. But anyway, we'll drive along this fence here. What you can see, there's bush to the right, but just down the bottom of this paddock is a big line of trees, what goes back to the entrance to get out of this place. So I'll drive down here and just look through. I know there's plenty more turnip weeds I've got to come back and get. But anyway, while I'm driving along down this road, or this paddock, once we get to those big line of trees just down there, we'll drive along there slowly, look for the turnip weeds, and I'll also have a look out for any old bottles. So you just never know, good place where they would have thrown their old bottles back in the old days when they're, you know, picking rocks and so forth.
A few bottles, guys. These ones are really modern. Just down here, looks like to be an old whiskey bottle. Just there, and I would like a hip flask bottle. I'll probably throw it away because they are pretty common. And just over here, there's a few more. We'll have a look.
Aluminium pot I'll take for my scrap.
All there, guys. Probably a racehorse going out of that one. Would live in there. And even it would probably compete with a snake.
So that's what that bottle says. This bottle is property of the United Distillers. So it's an old whiskey bottle.
No, nothing special, guys. But I tell you what, it always pays to drive along the old bush tracks like this in the bush. Always people would throw the bottles out of the driving cars, or they'd farmers would dump, you know, rubbish in certain areas. And if you've got any farmer friends, just make sure you get permission, or if there's a road like this one here, just drive along the road and maybe hop out of your car, and even if you just walk along the fence line, you're guaranteed of finding old bottles. Oh, here's a good one, guys. Lucky I stopped. Nice old retro 1960s Schweppes bottle. Look at that. Beautiful. I'll be, take that home. That's a nice find. And more, guys. Another nice old Schweppes. Beautiful find. Got to be happy with that. So this would probably date back probably 1960s onwards possibly. And you can just say here probably the farmers come along and dumped his rubbish on the side of the road. So like I say, guys, listen to the tips I give you, and I guarantee you, you'll find old bottles and relics along bush track. Another one, guys. So that's not too bad. A bit faded, but still, I'll probably leave that one there. Someone else can pick it up maybe one day.